So to show that equivalence is undecidable, we should first start out with a program for which we want to decide the halting problem. And that should be P. So we start out with this step here. Then we add a second program, and that program is called P prime, and it goes into an infinite loop. So no matter what input, this program is just programmed to always go into an infinite loop. Once we have those two programs, P and P prime, we run them through the algorithm that decides equivalence. And what that will do is it will basically ask, does the program P, for which we want to decide the halting problem, do the same thing as a program that always goes into an infinite loop? And then, of course, that means if the two programs are indeed equivalent, then P will also go into an infinite loop, because all that P prime is doing is it always goes into an infinite loop. And we don't even need the other two building blocks, because we have now shown that you can use equivalence to solve the halting problem. You just compare any program for which you want to decide the halting problem to a program that always goes into an infinite loop. And if they do the same thing, then they are equivalent, so you know that P will not halt. And if they are not equivalent, well, then P halts. Now, this was certainly one of the tougher quizzes in this course, so congratulations for figuring it out. But of course, I also trust that by now you have learned the ropes of theoretical computer science. Your reward here is that I will give you a third proof of undecidability for free.